What's going on, guys? This is Marcel from One Dapper Street, and there's a cab right there. Welcome to my channel, and welcome to today's video. Since so many of you watched the top pieces from H&M and then asked for me to do this with other stores, I'm on my way to Zara right now here in Soho.
Right over there.
And I'll just do the same thing. I'm gonna go through, see what my favorite pieces are, and then hopefully I wanna be able to create a couple of looks to show you guys, so let's hop inside. First round of selects, guys. Got some stuff here. Now I get to try everything on. That was crazy. Oh my god. There was a lot more people than I thought there was gonna be, but it was cool. I made friends with the entire store, which is great because one of my homies works there. Literally, I talked to everybody that was working at that Zara. And I got a bunch of stuff, so now it's already dark because it took longer, but I'll see you in the studio in a second, and it's gonna be tomorrow and bright out. And that's how quickly it is tomorrow. Here we are in the studio with all the pieces I picked. It ended up being 15. Got that? 15. Oh yeah. Which is a little bit more than what I had in the H&M video. If you haven't seen that yet, go check that out. And we're pretty heavy on outerwear, just because Zara is really strong in outerwear. But I'll walk you through that piece by piece. Let's not waste any more time and start with this pimpin' coat. Literally pimpin'. This piece is very unique. I am in love with it. Like, you put it on and you basically look like a polar bear. It's definitely gonna keep you warm. Something about it, the cut is not too crazy big that actually makes it wearable over a suit. I don't have one here to show you, but hopefully I'll have a photo soon, so I'll put that up on Instagram. If you don't follow me on Instagram just yet, right here. It's right there.
Click right there.
So that's the first piece, first outerwear, probably the most unique, outstanding of all the pieces that we got today. So don't be scared off if this is not your vibe. Staying with the warm and comfy jackets, here we have a faux shirling jacket. I love the light gray color. It's something I haven't really seen. Being faux fur, it's obviously a lot cheaper than real fur. One of the only places I let myself get away with a bulky jacket is if it's shearling. I don't personally even like puffer jackets.
Like, they just make you look kind of like...
But for these, I just let it slide because I think it just works for the look, and I'm just a big fan of shearling. That's why we have this. All black. Faux shearling as well. It's a beautiful sleek leather jacket with silver trims. When you pop up the collar, you have these two beautiful buckles that really make this jacket an absolute treasure. The fit on this is excellent, and we have one more buckle detail here down to the side. I don't know if you guys noticed, I'm a huge fan of buckles. I don't know why, something about them just works for me. So this is jacket number three, and we're definitely getting a little bit more easily wearable than the first two jackets that we had. Coat option number four, and possibly my favorite because this thing you can wear endlessly. Definitely works on top of a suit. Works on top of anything. As soon as you pop the collar, the entire thing becomes a lot more casual. It's a classic three-button overcoat, but the really well-designed window pane that's just so minimal with the dark gray lines across the entire jacket is what sets this guy apart from a more straightforward, single-color, no-pattern overcoat. I love this thing, and I actually hadn't bought this yesterday at Zara because I already bought it just for myself, regardless of this video today. That's how much I love it. And the fist jacket is this guy right here. It's a patterned bomber jacket. It's a lot lighter. It's not nearly as outdoor ready as the other four jackets we looked at just now. I love this thing. The colors are beautiful. We have a navy, we have Bordeaux, we have kind of like a burnt orange or burnt yellow. The one thing I will say about statement jackets like this, you have the design on the back. It's a very unique piece. If you get this from Zara and I walk down the street and bump into somebody that's literally wearing the same jacket, I always think it's a little bit weird. This is one of the instances where I think a designer jacket is a lot more rare, that's a lot more unique because there's just less pieces of it out there, may come in handy. Regardless, I love this jacket and I'm just gonna roll the dice and hope I don't run into anybody randomly.
Cause that would get awkward really quick.
And that makes this number five of my pieces from Zara this fall winter season. Next up, we have a blazer that could definitely double as a jacket too. As I said, very outerwear heavy, I'm sorry guys. I am in love with this. The fabric itself is a beautiful color, has a great texture to it. It's thick enough to keep you warm. And then you have the navy vest that's sewn in, but you can zip it out if you don't like it. I personally think it has almost a Brunello Cucinelli type of vibe. If you guys don't know that brand, especially in terms of styling, it's one of my favorite brands out there. They do beautiful stuff. And if you flip up the collar, you have this natural suede effect. I love this jacket. I think it's very, very versatile. And I think it's, for one, super comfortable, but also dressy as hell, even with the little elbow patches. Piece number six. One layer down, we have this sweater right here. And I was sold as soon as I saw the color. The fit itself is kind of relaxed and I like that a lot. It's a medium weight sweater, so you can actually wear it underneath or on top. But again, I just think this, what is that even? Like a lavender type pinkish? It's just faded enough so it comes off a lot more masculine than a true pink would.
But in any case, real men wear pink, right?
And I think it's just a nice sweater to add a little bit of pop of color from underneath. So it's the winter. You're obviously wearing a lot of coats and stuff on top. So if you're wearing a big coat that's like the second coat that we looked at, the gray shearling, this is just a nice pop of color from underneath to make the look a little bit more vibrant and to bring a little bit of color and energy into the cold and cloudy world out there. Let's talk turtlenecks because I'm wearing one and that's actually one of the 15 pieces, but we also have this. So I have one off-white thin layering piece. I just love turtlenecks because I have a long neck. Even if you don't have a long neck, I think these look amazing. If you actually have a short neck, I would recommend you guys go for a mock neck, not a turtleneck. That's kind of like a turtleneck equivalent. It just stops right here. Similar aesthetic. This guy right here is a little bit heavier. I love the dark navy. I think it's really classy, and Zara actually makes really great turtlenecks. Every season I go out and buy several turtlenecks from all over the place, and I often find myself wearing the ones from Zara. So these are the two turtlenecks. Before we move on to bottoms, where we have four options, I want to show you two scarves really quick that I think are amazing. Number one, this scarf right here. It's got dark brown, white. What else we got? Caramel type notes, and then we have a little bit of green in the trim on the scarf. I think it's great to add texture to the look because it's a very unique texture. It definitely keeps you warm, but it's also kind of light, so you know how you step out and it's freezing and then you're inside and it just gets really hot really quick. Well, I think this thing is pretty great at transitioning from inside to outside. This option right here is definitely a lot cleaner in its look. It's primarily an off-white, it's a very clean knit, and then we have some navy detail on both ends, which I think is great. I mean, you guys know I love navy. If you do too, I think the scarf could be amazing for you because I think it's great to add a little bit of lightness to the look. Most guys don't wear a lot of bright colors in the winter. I like it, I'm a big fan of winter whites, and this thing is a very easily integrated piece to make that happen. Okay, so let's talk bottoms. Right now I'm wearing dark blue jeans. These are actually a straight fit, which really worked for me till right about here, and then they become a little bit too loose for me, so I'm probably gonna drop them off at the tailor. But with that said, I really do like the fit up here. I like the tobacco stitching as a detail. I think it's a classy option, and I think it's just a wonderful staple to have in your closet. Why is this part of my 15 favorites video, even though it's such an essential? Honestly, I walked past and I just saw the color and I thought the color looked amazing. Don't know what exactly attracted me to it, but it just is one of my favorite pieces that I could pick up, and that's why they're here. Let's stick with navy for right now. These pants I actually also bought a couple of weeks prior to my visit yesterday to Zara. I love these. They're a navy base, but then they have a tan and brown check pattern on it. They're very tapered, but kind of almost baggy or like loose around the crotch, which makes for a very modern fit. And it also comes with a little detail. Right here, it comes with a chain and then this little pocket thing. If you don't like it, cut it off, but I think it's cool just to give you the option. And they're very easily dressed up or dressed down, which is actually kind of true for the next couple of pants also. Let's look at those. Right here we have a light gray and black puppy tooth almost. It's a very small houndstooth pattern, and these pants fit very similarly to the ones we just took a look at. I'm not 100% sure, but the fact that it also has a chain and the thing makes me think that this is literally the identical pant, just in a different fabric and a different pattern. But as I told you, I love the fit of the first one, and this is actually a very different look than the other one. So both of those make it to the favorites. Last but not least, this looks very basic. It kind of has a wool aesthetic, which I think is awesome because it's very dressed up, but they're stretchy as hell. Like so stretchy. Which makes them insanely comfortable to wear. They're kind of a medium thickness, so at the coldest of days, you might have to wear something underneath. I think these are a great, great option. I'm always all four pieces that you can dress up and down, and this you can dress all the way up and still feel like it's dressed all the way down, so winner. And as quick as that, we're through my 15 favorite pieces. I gotta say, this time when I walked through Zara, it was a little bit difficult. There wasn't a section where I looked and it was like, oh, I like everything. You really had to go through and pick things out. The pieces that I did find, I'm really in love with, so I hope it kind of helps you guys navigate through the store right now, because I gotta say, there was a lot of product in there that I just didn't like. For right now, let's take the tags of all of these things, and I'm gonna show you a few looks that you can create with these pieces. Oh, one quick note, total damage was just under $1,500. Not a cheap thing altogether, but obviously you don't need all of this. This is really me just pulling everything I liked a lot, and then you can choose whatever you want. Links are gonna be down below in the description. Let's take a look
at the outfits. Telling me I just crash again.
Shit, I think I know what you mean.
Pretty good for a time machine. You gave me a smile, stood there for a while. That was when you woke me up.
All this time I didn't know I had my heart on standby. That it is love that I am feeling inside.
Those are the looks. Once again, I hope you guys liked the pieces that I picked and the looks that I created today for you guys. Let me know if you did, let me know what you didn't like. Comment down below, let's start a conversation about fashion because I love talking about fashion, that's why I'm doing what I'm doing. If you did like the video, drop that thumbs up down below. Subscribe to my channel if you like what you're seeing because we're producing this type of content all the time. 90% is about men's fashion, so you're at the right place if you're looking for that. And at this point, I want to say goodbye. Thank you so much for watching and I'll see you in a few days with the next video. Bye, guys.